start taking out the chat.
You say good at already, but you got a good man. You got a good man. Honey, I'm going to start paying the bills with my money. And you keep your money.
Well.
Hello, sir. My Lord. Do what you want with it, honey. Go get a pedicure and a manicure. Get you a new hat and dress. Go out and get you, oh, get some folk in trouble. Let me move on.
My Lord.
Hello, somebody. But in the text, it was practical service.
Right.
True love is very practical. But it's like you dating a man and you don't have a car and he won't ever take you nowhere where you need to go. He just showing you how you're going to be in marriage. Hello, somebody. Practical service. And that's what true love is, to say practical service. It gives what needs to be given. It does what needs to be done. Jesus Christ gave us a practical service because there was nobody who was worthy to die for the sins of the world. He needed to, or we needed a perfect man to die. Oh, but there was no perfect man.
Yeah.
So God had to come and get off that throne. Come and manifest himself as a man and do this practical service. Die for the sins of the world.
Yes,
if you're married to a man that's not willing to die, you need to pray. Single women, you got to marry a man that's willing to die. Hold God to himself, God to his selfish ways, and be willing to sacrifice for the family. Die to from his selfish ways and be willing to serve the family.
Man.
Hello, son. Hello, somebody. That's what she did in the text. Luke 7:44 puts the move on. And then she turned towards the woman and said to Simon. Jesus was telling them what really happened because they didn't really know.
Right.
He said, do you see this woman?
Right.
I came into your house and you did not give me any water for my feet.
Right.
It was an insult.
Right.
But she wet my feet with her tears and wiped him with her hair.
All right.
Talking about humility.
Mm-hmm.
You're willing to humble yourself and become a true servant of God, regardless of who is looking. Hello, somebody. Regardless that you got the big wigs in the house, are you willing to serve?
All right.
Are you willing to do what needs to be done? Hello, somebody. And she did it. She didn't have water, but she had tears. Oh, she didn't have a towel, but she had her own hair. Wow. God always gives something to serve him with. You might say, I don't have anything to serve. Yeah, he always gives you something.
Man.
All right.
To serve him with.
Right.
Hello, somebody. Lastly, before I keep us too long, true love is for sinners. Text says, therefore I tell you, her many sins have been forgiven. As her grace what?
Love.
Has shown. Whoever has been forgiven little,
Lord help me.
Great ways that you know whether a person has a true relationship with God.
Right.
Is that they are a lavish giver.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
They give their money and they give their service.
Right.
That's a sign of true salvation. That's a sign of that you truly love God.
Yes, sir.
It's not just sending your money alone. It's serving.
All right.
It's not just serving alone. But it's giving. Hello, somebody. If you say that you love Bethlehem, let me look at your giving. To which I don't know how much you give. That's the bottom line of many preachers do know. Something's wanting to let you serve in a leadership if you're not giving.
Come on, God.
Hello, somebody. If you truly love the Lord and the principles of true love that helps us to apply this to our church members, apply it to our church, apply it to our church members, apply it in our lives, in our marriages, that we've got to be sacrificial lovers. We've got to be lovers who serve. We've got to be a love, show our love towards God so much that sinful folk want to get saved. And really, that's the mystery of marriage. I'm going to teach on that a little later. The mystery of marriage is that the marriage is a model. The marriage is an image, if you would, of Christ's love towards the church.
Amen.
Can you go ahead and give God a hand clap of praise? The reason why there is so many and so much messed up stuff in our communities is we've gotten away from the image of marriage. We've gotten away from the model of marriage. Don't you know that marriage is evangelism?
Yes, sir.
Marriage is evangelism. You want to make him known. Love your wife. Some of us can't make them known because we don't love our lives, and we're running all over town out to these hood rats. Everybody in town knows you don't love your wife. Anita Baker, was it Anita Baker that said love should have brought you home last night? Love should have been with you. Love should have been right by your side. Hello, somebody. And even the secular world knows what true love should be. True love is one man committed to one woman for the rest of his life. Hello, somebody.
Yes,
sir. Many men say they want a ride or die chick, but are you a ride or die dude? Hello, somebody. Are you willing to commit, regardless of whether I'm happy or not, regardless of whether I get my needs met or not, I'm going to love this woman for the rest of my life. I'm going to love her as Christ loved the church. And Christ loved the church. And how did he love the church? He died. And not only that, but he lives for the church. Hello, somebody. Many of us are saying, this Valentine's Day, we'll be singing that song. The prince used to say, I would die for you. Like Bruno Mars coming out, I step in front of a train for you. Hello, somebody. Lying to you. Hello, somebody. A true love is for sinners. He set this up, this great evangelism too called marriage, to show the world of God's love. And there's no greater testimony like the testimony of a pastor I get to preach for. My wife's a real pastor there in Houston, Texas. She became terminally ill. She can't do nothing. But guess what? This man of God is still committed to her. And he's with her and by her side. And he loves her so much, even though he can't get his own needs met. He loves her. And that's the kind of love you want to have. You don't want to be like that brother that asked that sister to marry him, and he found out he had cancer, and she broke off the engagement. That's not true love.
Come on.
Love says, I'm going to be with you through it all, in it all, with it all. We're going to ride and die for Jesus Christ. And I'm going to love you all the days of my life till the Lord gives me breath.
Yes, sir.
My Lord.
Amen.
Hello, somebody. Amen. Will I get my own needs met or not?
Come on.
Hello, somebody. And that kind of testimony will tell the world about the kind of God that you serve.
Amen.
Hello, somebody.
Yeah.
Amen. Is that an image? if he can do that for, is that what God did for me?
Oh yeah.
Hello, somebody. And that means that even though how bad a life I lived, I was against her. Oh, no matter, I was a prostitute. No matter what I did, you mean God is so committed. For God is a ride or die God. He's going to be with me and love me regardless of everything that I've done in my past. He's a ride or die God. So, regardless of my fails, regardless of my blow it, as long as I confess my sins unto him, and you mean that he will have fellowship with me? That's the kind of God that we serve. Now, there's always consequences with it. But you can be forgiven for every sin that you have committed. You can be like this sinner woman in the tent, and you can come up and get a seat on the front row. In Jesus' name, you can bring your offering regardless of your past. You can serve the Lord regardless of your past.
From above, we